Start recording. Hello, YouTube. I don't think. Oh, yeah, no, I don't think I've put on the last YouTube video either. Whoops. So you're going to get 2 thick and fast. This will be the second one. I shall not delay them. I've got a funny feeling I didn't upload the last stream we did. But on that, YouTube peoples, don't fret that this is all, like, you know, distracted, not concise, and all the rest of it, YouTube crap, me just uploading VODs. I have decided what I'm going to do is, once this is all up and running, this version 2 of Twitch Plays, I am going to do a video series, basically pretending to create what has already been created, but do it as concise, you know, short videos, basically refactoring it, but not refunctionalitying it. So it'll be short and very educational in the whole point of the video. So for those of you on YubTubes who watch my stuff to get coding practice and ideas and that side of things, rather than just putting it on while you're doing the hoovering and background watching or whatever, there will be a version for that. So if you're not particularly interested in these long videos, then I will be doing that at some point. Obviously, I just do this for fun, so it's not going to be within the next couple of weeks. Yeah, once this is done and released, then it'll be on the cards to do that. And to be honest, it shouldn't be too difficult for me to just record them in the odd evenings and so on. So anyway, so we'll see. But that is the plan. That is very, very much the plan. And then once that's done and we're happy with this and any tweaks, because the Phasmo update is due out in a fortnight, so there's probably going to be some tweaks for that. I'm aiming for this to be released then, or before then, effectively, with then probably a hot fix if anything breaks when the actual game update comes out. So then once this is out of the way and, you know, signed, sealed, delivered, then I might start thinking about doing some C++ again. I want to do it. It is going to happen. It's just a matter of when it's going to happen. I think it's probably more likely to be later in the year, because I do still need to do my PhD corrections and get them submitted, and then everything's out of the way at that point. Cheers, by the way. That's just fucking perfect. 7 days ago, Mathman gave me a shout out to 69 viewers. That's class. But first of all, thank you very much, Mathman. You are a legend. Very good friend here. But also 69 viewers. Nice. I need to add that as a firebot thing, don't I? And here's something else I'm going to be doing soon. Probably sooner than everything else, actually. Not today, because I want to show off the GUI and this is only a short stream, but maybe next stream, and I'm going to try and do it as concise as I can so that it can just go on to YouTube sort of as is, but without all my usual waffly bullshit of stream, is a Nightbot. So for anyone who mods or is a broadcaster, using Nightbot, it'll be a Nightbot nerdy tutorial type. Maybe not tutorial, maybe that's the wrong word, but this is how you do some of the more advanced stuff. Yeah, advanced tutorial, fuck, that's the right word, isn't it? Of how you do some of the really, like, cool things that you can't do in other chatbots, like stream elements and slobs and all the, you know, Firebot know as well, but Firebot's built very different, so it's actually quite hard to compare the two. And runs locally, it's not a cloud service, whereas Nightbot is fully cloud, and you can do some really cool stuff with it. So let's get into it. We've got not very long before VK goes live, and we will be going to see the lovely VK because they are streaming today, so on Saturday this week, because they were working yesterday, so your normal schedule got pushed back a day. So if I click, let's do a click of that button. Yeah, there we go. So first of all, we're going to do a git pull, because I've, like before off stream, I've been busy. So code local workspace, here we go. Right then. So if you remember, we were working on a graphical user interface, a GUI. I don't want git blame, that's really annoying during streams, and I need to comment you out to, no I don't, I want to comment you in and have you set to, what was it, 1.5 were we using before? Is that not terrible on screen? And it could do with being a bit more, right? That's as good as you're going to get, folks. But feedback, you know, YouTube guys and so on, feedback in the comments or DM me or something if you don't want to put it in comments and feed the algorithm or whatever, I don't care. But yeah, let me know what this Zoom level is like and whether it's enough. I mean, I can go absolutely butt wild, right? And make it insane like this, which is obviously going to be better. But for me, I now can't see shit. So it's the balance of what works for you, but also works for me. And meeting it somewhere in the middle. Obviously, I want you guys to be able to see what the hell's going on. Otherwise, there's just no point in me even clicking the stream button, right? Equally, it needs to be workable for me, otherwise there's no point in me doing the work. So it's the balance between the two. Right then, without further ado, let's hit F5 and see what happens, shall we? Because I've been doing this all on Linux. Okay, cool. Right, so we have this lovely canvas that I've just clicked off by mistake. We have this lovely canvas with the green Tato background that you can't see much of at the moment because of this disgusting disgusting frame in the middle of it. Work in progress. Created by the wonderful Sheenie down here. She signed it. She did this for me. So it's got my drone. It's what I do for a real job. My chicken, my lake chicken. My bees, so I still have my bees in the garden, beekeeper, mushrooms, mushroom hatter, yeah, fabulous pumpkins, because last year I grew pumpkins, and all sorts. But anyway, so, and we've got this, and I will add, in fact, we should do this today. So there's a non-clickable, like, embedded bit of text here. I can't zoom on this, I'm afraid. So it says connected to Green Giant, so that is the channel we're connected to at the moment, which you can see down in the log down here. This is the version, so we now have the version number in the GUI, and I've also put that in the TOML file, so in the textual config file it has the version number. So then if we do a release that is breaking, when we read that config file in with the new version that has a breaking change, we can detect, ah, this is old version, so this needs to go through a function first to bring it into the new version, overwrite the file, and we can save, you know, the effort that whoever has set up, and we can have some sort of conversion function to convert between the old and the new if I have to make a breaking change, which hopefully, you know, won't need to do, but who knows what the future holds. So yeah, so we've got our drop down list here. I've moved this to the top because it sort of makes more sense of all our different commands. And if we add a command, it just automatically pops up on this list. Fantastic. And we've got our enabled here. So why did I comment out the other thing? So I've broken a lot of the commonality out into functions now, so it's been generalized quite a lot, which is nice. Sorry, I'm scrolling through this at lightning speed. We will go through this in a moment. So I can't remember why I commented all this out now. Well, let's see what happens. I think I know why. Because I was working on the merger of the runtime and the static data. Which is a bit annoying because that doesn't lend itself to a stream very well. But here we go. Right, you have no fucking idea, excuse my language, how long it took to line these two up. Oh, and it's not lined up with the enabled anymore. Why does it do that? So tkinter, which is the package we're using, I'm clearly using it wrong, but I don't know how, because I've spent hours on this. I don't know why I need stream mode onto... Oh, okay. Oh shit, now I need to figure out how the hell I turn it on when I've manually turned it off. Sorry, one momento. Enable, here we go. Super, maybe that worked. I should do some PR, right? Should I do some PR? Let's do a quick bit of PR. So let's copy that. And let's do a bit of... Thank you for the heads up on that, by the way. One sec. Where's the live feed and promo? Here we are. Oh, VK's already added me to the auto thing. Well, thank you. I'm only going to do it in channels that like I'm very active in. Otherwise, it's just a bit spammy, right? And those people know me and they know whether they're going to enjoy it or not. Promote yourself. Here we are. So, Eldels, I think I've got the right to post this in Eldels. Why not? If I haven't, well, I'll ban everyone else. For Twitch Plays stream. Short Twitch Plays Programming stream. There we go. Let's do one of them. So is it? Yeah, okay, fine. Sorry, this is die. I should have done this before going live. I'm an idiot. It'd be just nice for a few people to pop in and say hi. And it's only a short stream, so... Where's... God, I suck at Discord. I really do. Oh, here we are. Self-promo. I don't have permission to post in this channel. I'm a mod. Screw you guys. I dare do a self-promo in another channel. That's... Maybe not do that. Let's not do that. Anyone else I want to bang that in? No. Wonder if I'm on Shushi's auto shout out in chat. I need to speak to them about that actually, because I don't feel like I don't stream enough to be worthy of that. Self-promo, here we are. I'm not on the Discord one. Let's just bang that in there. Cool, right, that'll do. Fine, that's enough. I can't stand doing that sort of thing, so let's not. So, right, alignment. Okay, so alignment is driving me absolutely up the wazoo. And I don't know why that's now just fucking moved. But anyway, what we have is actually, if I comment, remove these nine comments, maybe that's why this was commented out. Yeah, because it's broken these two as well. And getting these two lined up was a nightmare, but then getting them lined up with the other bits. So actually, it looks like it's these two that are broken, because that one and the two sliders are fine. So, what you'll notice here, right, is we now have generic function calls to make those frames. So, this grey box is a frame, and then within that we have a frame that contains this enabled and the tick box, and another frame that contains command and then this text box, and another frame that contains keybind. Right, you see where this is going, okay? But they need to be aligned, or the internals of those frames need to be aligned with another frame that is external, and that's sort of the hard bit. And I've not quite figured out why it's doing it, because we just have to delve into this, right? The thing that's throwing me are these width parameters. Because when you create a frame, you effectively, you give it pixels, right? And when you create the canvas, you give it pixels. So you know exactly it's this number wide, and this is what the definition of one width is. It's one pixel. Right, happy days. That's not true here. Because, like, for example, so this text box is, let's stick a breakpoint on that, is a frame width of 400 pixels, right? So let's just pull that up. So 400 pixels across, but the width of tick box is a bad example. The width of this entry frame, which is the text box entry, is 25. Well, clearly, you know, here to here. Oh, I can do the print screen thing, can't I? Clearly, if here to here is 400, then here to here is clearly not 25. Right? It's 180, maybe. You know, give or take a margin. But eyeballing it, it's a bit less than half. Half is 200, it's a bit less than that. Let's stab at 180, right? But the number I give is 25 to do that. Right, and if I expand this, so let's say I make it 40. Right, you see it's gone, it's actually gone off the end. I don't think it has gone off the end, but now you can see we've gone beyond this bit. So actually the real number is probably, well, like, let's take a stab at 36. I don't know, fucking numbers out of my arse here. No, 30. And this is basically what I'd be, well, since I've learnt, so 30 is too small, look. And we've lost a bit here randomly. I say randomly, actually it's not random, because this box is anchored west. Pack right hand side. Let's just check that. I've checked this so many times, but sorry, it's anchored east. Wait, it's anchored east? If that's anchored east and packed on the right, then why the fuck's there a gap here? I'm losing my mind. I am losing my mind. Assuming I had any to lose, but there we go. Oh. Dream is raiding out. Just do a quick copy and paste. Right, so this is taking much manual tweaking. So, hang on, what was that? That was too small. Text frames for 30 was too small. 36 was too big. So let's go 33. Maybe that's the number we need. Actually, that looks really good. In fact, you can tell it's not bang on. But visually, it's close enough. And there is no way. So this is the problem I've got, right? Is there's not a programmatic way that I found of doing this. Or a procedural way. Sorry, not programmatic. It makes sense. Because the frame width is 400, right? So I want this to be 180, but it's not that number. This number seems to be in a different... Well, it's certainly in a different unit, but it's also... doesn't seem to be linear, not linear, wrong word. It doesn't seem to be directly proportional to that 400. I'm sure it probably is. I'm not convinced it is. Because, you know, I just want to take frame width here, which is 400. We have that hard coded, and I want, maybe someone knows how to do this, and I want to assign this label to be 50% of that, and then this whatever it is, whether it's a tick box or blah blah blah, to be able to use 50% of the right side, so 200 200, right? And I want it to be aligned straight down the middle. So these are effectively like anchored to the right, and then these are anchored to the left, or east and west. Which is different to justify, that was a rabbit hole I went down, justify of a text box, of a label only actually does anything if it's a multi-line label. So, whatever, right? Shit, VK's just gone live. I thought I had an hour. Oh, no, they did say it was going to be an hour early. Hey, I'm Ellen. No, Jack, I'm not. I'm using tkinter. So it's a Python... It's like the most famous, most used Python GUI thing. It's the first GUI I've ever made in my life. But no, it isn't CSS. I've got a really funny picture of CSS, actually. Did I save this? Oh, I haven't. Where's this? Because you'll like this. Yeah, here it is. Can I just open image in new tab? There you are. World's best CSS developer. What a great trophy that is. That is so good. Well, only if you'll... Hello, Sheenie. Only if you'll allow me to. It's still work in progress, right? I've, like, put this disgusting grey box around most of it, but that's not the final... Hopefully the final product. Hopefully this can be cut down and have transparency and stuff. I'm still working out how the feck you do it, though. Yeah, it's good, isn't it, Jack? Yeah. But no, I don't have CSS. So basically, this tkinter package, like you create labels and you can anchor it left or right and you put that in a frame and you can give it widths, and this width doesn't actually correspond to pixels. This is the problem I'm having. This width is some random fucking, I don't know. Whereas this width is pixels. So, like, you just have to manually tune it, which is going to drive me insane in the membrane, because, like, although I've just lined that up there, so if I change this to, like, 36, right? So not a very big change. Look how it's like fucking miles off here now. But the problem is that was lined up before, and then I added something else somewhere, you know, and then all the widths changed, despite that being a hard-coded number. So I clearly don't understand this enough, but equally I've banged my head against Stack Overflow and the documentation, all the rest of it, and it doesn't seem to help. The only mention I see is that this is screen units. Why does it say that? It was in the type in. Yes, yeah, screen units here. Oh, that's border width. That's not the right one. Where's width? Fuck me, my eyes. Width. Here we go. Oh no, width is an int on this one. But I've seen screen units, but like, it doesn't. I don't know what that means. Is it a percentage? So anyway, I might make a ghosty one, might be more fitting. I wouldn't say no. I'd love it if you want to do it, that'd be amazing. I made this so I have to have a hard-coded, what's the button, it's that one, like size of pixels, but that's fine, I can just crop. So your one was 1920x1080, I think, the original of this. So I cropped it down to 640x480, which is exactly what this window is, this 640x480, which I think is a good size for a window, right? Because if I expand this, you can see what happens. So, you know, it needs to be a thing. And if this was full screen, like, I just don't have enough information to fit on a full screen like that. And equally, I think for a streamer, that'd be quite annoying. When you got your OBS up and your Firebot and your this and your that and so on. It's just nice to have this a little bit smaller. I mean, maybe it could even be... I mean, if I do that, though, you're not going to see any of the graphics. Because I'm not sure... I don't think I can make this transparent. So I'm just going to have to trim it as much as I can. I can change the colour. I just can't change the opacity. Opacity? Opacity? Is that a word? I'm not right, not all right, I'm half left. Shake my head. What are you trying to build? Yeah, so it's basically a GUI for this TwitchPlays software, because although I'm perfectly happy with a TOML file like this, that, you know, there's your command, it's enabled, this is the cooldown, some random chance, this is your keybind, which, you know, any normal person would have set to W. The duration that the command works for, so it's pressing this key for 3 seconds. And the command you type in Twitch chat is the word forward. Likewise for backwards, except you can actually have back or backwards as the Twitch command, and it presses S. And then there's more funky shit down here, like you can do disco and there's some configuration on that and so on and so forth, right? I'm happy with the text file, I understand the text file, I wrote the fucking thing. But your average person who's not a programmer, who, well, even if they were, didn't write the software, this is just nicer. So you have your list of all your commands and it gives you the information for each one. So, you know, if you wanted to have a random chance of the command working of 40%, you go to that command, you roll it to 40, it shows up in here, and then it's set, right? Ignore this, I've broken the refresh on this, so which is why this isn't updating. So yeah, it's just a nice GUI, and you can select the thing, and it's just easier to use. That's purely all it's about, right? Can you make it responsive so it scales? Not 100% sure I know what you mean. So the image that's a background, right, is called a canvas, right? That's just the terminology it's used. That is static. That is 640 by 480 because that's what I made the image. Which is this image here, right? That it's just a .png file. So that won't scale because it is static. That is what the thing is. You know, that's it. I'm not sure. I mean, it's programming. I can do anything, but it would be a pain in the dick, and I don't think it would be worth it to be able to, you know, if you stretch this window down, it stretches the image down. I could do it with image processing and stuff like that. It's just like, why? What I can do, and what you can see, is that these frames are, so this is tiled in the center of the window. This is tiled in the center of the window, pinned north. And as the window changes, this is still in the center, this is still in the center, pinned north. Whereas this stuff and these text boxes don't. So that can sort of scale. Now, scale's not the right word, it's the positioning. Scales more like if I make this twice the size, everything just gets twice as big. That I don't know, actually, because I don't even know if I've got a callback for when this window gets changed. Because what I'm doing here, changing the window size, is happening in Microsoft Windows. It's not happening in my code. It's happening in Microsoft Windows. I don't know if there's a callback for an on change of window size. I'm sure there probably is. Again, it would be a lot of code, and I'd rather it just be static. And maybe there's just a setting I can do that stops you being able to do this. So it's a fixed size, so you don't get the expanding and closing arrows. But equally, like, could leave it in because, well, whatever. I don't know. This is all just thoughts at the moment. So, hi Sam, are you back home yet? No, well, I know nothing about this package, to be honest. So, although I'm good at programming, I'm at the mercy of what this library allows me to do. So, to be honest, we're both in the same amount of darkness here. So it looks like I've vaguely got these manually lined up. Maybe this actually wants to be 32. So I can see it's just slightly too big. And now it's slightly more too small. So actually, no, 33 is the right number until something else changes. I'm loving this music, by the way. Is the audio balance okay? Because I'm using Stream Beats that Mort recommended, and it's coming through browser rather than where I normally play the Stardew from. AFK, no worries. Hi Traylon, how you doing? Oh, you're muted. I wave. Sumi, hello. Hello. Go and say hello to VK. Don't, I'm not pinching the viewers. I thought I had another hour, but I got my time zones wrong. So we won't be going too much longer because I won't pinch my friends' viewers. I just wanted to show off how this is doing. So I've just changed that back to 33, so that's better. So this alignment here. Now, the way to do it that I understand is that I turn this this frame, so this grey box here is a frame that you can put stuff in. It's just like an environment. Is that I make this a grid. So at the moment, and if I use the print screen tool, if I draw the frames, right? So this is a frame. This is a variable that has a name. And then I make a frame within the frame, right? And let's change the color. Let's do green. No, let's not do red and green. Holy crap. I have some idea of how color blindness works. Right, and within this frame, I create this frame. And within that frame, I have a label and I have a checkbox. And then within the red frame, I create another frame, which is this one. And then I create another frame and another frame and another frame. And this is how this is built, right? So what I'm trying to do is align that is the word, here. But the problem with that is that line effectively belongs to, because it's with respect to, this red box, which doesn't exist in this dark blue box. And it certainly doesn't exist that, so this dark blue box here, yeah, I didn't want to do that. Let's do that color. This dark blue box has no knowledge of this dark blue box. So where this is would need to be passed into the variables, right? Into each of these variables. But these are agnostic of absolute position. So I don't think that's possible. What I need to do is basically not have these dark blue frames. I create a label and I pin it top left and I pin the action top right. And then I create this label, pin it top left, but with priority of 2. And then I create this thing and pin it top right with a priority of 2. So it ends up underneath and then these can be lined up, right? And that's effectively creating a grid. Which you can do in Kinter. So I think that's probably what I'm going to have to do. Now let me exit this draw on screen mode because I can't see anything typed in chat when I do that. I'm not going to be on long, see me. Like 10 minutes tops. Yeah, I'm doing well, thank you. I'm doing well. Frame section. Yeah, I just use the print screen tool so I can draw on the screen, but because then that freezes everything else, I can't see chat when I do that. Losing signal. No worries, Sam. I'm not going to be on long anyway. We'll go to VKs in a sec. So that's where I'm at. But as you can see, you know, this is doing stuff, and if I type hello in here, you know, we're getting the callbacks and so on and so forth. It needs tidying up. Basically, the main challenge is this alignment. And at the moment, what I need to do is, if you remember, we have... I'm just going to stick a breakpoint there and then move the random chance so that fires. So we have this runtime parameter that we move everywhere, right? Which is used a lot in game programming. It's like a global environment, effectively. I hate it. It's very much goes against what I would do in embedded stuff. Moving an environment around everywhere. Normally that's a sign of bad structure, but for this type of thing, which is very different to what I'm used to doing, I can't see another way of doing it. You either pass the data around, and because this is Python, this is reference counted, so it's a reference rather than a copy. The other option is to pass callbacks everywhere, which I hate the idea of even more. But we have this runtime thing, right, which has got our runtime dictionary that has our runtime data for each of the commands. So this is whether or not we can use it. So if a command comes in from chat, is it available to use now? And remember, that predicate is based on, is it enabled in the config? So we can just disable it outright. Is it on cooldown? Is it currently in use? And as long as the predicates for each of those three things are satisfied, then yes, we can use it. Otherwise, no, we can't use it because it's either disabled, it's currently in use already, so there's no point doing it again, or it's on cooldown. Or it fails the random chance. But I don't think that's part of the can use predicate, actually. It's more of the runtime thing. We've got a last used variable, so this is basically the time, this is epoch time, of when the command was last used, so that's how we can calculate our cooldown. So if someone does it again, we check when was it last used, is now minus last used greater than cooldown. Keybind and random chance percentage and blah blah blah, right? So we have that runtime dictionary, but we also have our action list, and this contains other information, like, for example, which is the static data, so the data that doesn't change at runtime. So, like, the time it was last used changes at runtime based on when it was last used, right? And this is constantly updated throughout the program. The static data is set when you run the when you start the program, and doesn't change for the lifetime of the program, unless you change it in the GUI. But this is where the problem is. So, for example, what is the command you type in chat? Right, that doesn't change because of last time. It's set. You set that when you start the program. The key binds, you know, the duration that it goes on for, the tag and these things. So we've got these two bits of important data that are not, they're in different places and they're in different formats. This is a list. This is a dictionary. So we need to merge those together. I need to merge these together, right? And the reason I need to do that is because this callback that is then going to change something. So this is going to change the random chance. Well, this actually needs to set it in, well, is it the action list or is it the runtime dictionary? It's in the runtime dictionary. Whereas actually this belongs in the action list because it belongs in static data. And the keybind doesn't belong in here, it belongs in the action list. So there's two different bits of important information that need to be merged together. And the reason they're not, if you remember when we architected this, was the runtime stuff is more game oriented and the action is more Twitch oriented. So this is Twitch, right? It's a command you type in Twitch, and it's an action. It presses a button and has a duration, right? Whereas the runtime stuff is more game-oriented, so it's the cooldown and things like that. It's a wishy-washy barrier, border, and I think it needs to be merged. So I'll do that off-stream. But anyway, so that's where we've got to. I am going to cut it short there. Because V is on, so we're going to go and see V. Bad excuse for never reading chat. Yeah, I know, isn't it? I almost got away with it, though. If it wasn't for you pesky kids. Can't stand to read your messages, I know. This is why I don't code, yeah. Well, you know, I've never done a GUI in my life. Graphical user interface. I've never used this library in my life for the same reason. It's very much not my norm. It's a long way out of what I normally do. So I'm really using it as a bit of a learning tool. But also I think it would just add so much value to the software. like so much value and usability and so on. So I think it's worth the effort. So yeah, that's where we are. We're going to call it there. Super, super short, right? But there's an update of what I'm up to off stream. This does work. In fact, let me just show you. So this is in Windows, right? Let me show you. That also, although you can't do this in Phasmo, because Phasmo doesn't work in Linux. Let me just log in to my laptop. Here we are. So I have exactly the same code on here. I appreciate you're not going to be able to read that, but you can see this is Ubuntu. Hopefully anyone who's used to Linux recognizes that's Ubuntu. And what I can do is... right, webcam's going to be gash on this, I appreciate, but if I press F5 now, if I can find the button, looking at it backwards, you can see it pops up and works. Yeah, okay, resolution sucks ass. But this is running in Ubuntu. So this also works on Linux. So if you had a bit of Linux software that you wanted to use this for, i.e. not Phasmo, because Phasmo doesn't work on Linux. Unlike lots of Steam games, maybe it's going to come in the portability update. I don't know. That'd be good. I'd like that a lot. But yeah. So it works on Linux. Won't work on WSL, because the Windows subsystem for Linux doesn't have an X environment, so it doesn't have a windowed environment. So, let's go and share all the love to VK, and let's not type /raid in VK's channel, because that would be fucking hilarious. So let's do a /raid. You're supposed to be driving, man. VK TV. The short stream, thank you very much for being here.